And if I remember correctly, both of the segmented runs actually use the first key to open up the town door. And then they go into that town, and then they get, like, their... they get, like, a level up from the initial monsters that you wind up fighting. And then they come back out and fight the boss with the full health. And the spell, actually. Wait, what am I... So the reason why dying is just a reset, it's not a game over, actually. You don't, or can't, game over in this game. So the reason it's a game over is that when you die, you drop, I think, half of your almas, and 100% of all of your gold. Late in the run, I wind up having a considerable amount of gold just floating around my inventory. Like, to the tune of, you know, 5, 6, 7,000, something like that. Depending on exactly where I am. Man, go away. Bats. Why? So the monetary loss is something that I can't recover from. Is one. The other reason why it's just a run-over is because when you respawn in the first town, so you have to make your way all the way through all of the labyrinths that you, you know, that you had to go through in order to get to back to where you were, which is, yeah, that sucks. This is a little bit better. It's actually a lot better. For the fight, anyways. A couple of times there. So I may as well show off what this terrible spell does. Hang on a minute. Make it to this platform. There we go. So that's it. It's this really, really short-range spell. It barely goes, like, I don't know, a few meters in front of you. And it doesn't even do enough damage to outright kill anything in, stop with the axes. Jesus, dude. It doesn't do enough damage to kill anything in the area that you get it in. Much less any of the other areas. So it's, I don't know, maybe it's pretty. Like, ooh. I wouldn't actually go in to see that wise woman at all if I didn't need to get a level up there. I would just skip getting this spell entirely, because it's just... so terrible. Okay. kind of fist bumped the octopus a little bit, so my positioning was off. I didn't want to go up to speed none. Tentacle bumped. Used to be a really high death area for me in the early game. Oh man. It still has the potential to be. I'm definitely better than I was when I started, but you need to get kind of lucky. Sometimes, too. All right, I'm doing it. I'm gonna start saving. 'Cause I think I have a tremendous amount of time for more runs of this, so I want to finish out at least one of these. So I'll start saving here. I mean, it's not a tremendous amount of time to spend in terms of saving. You know, it's like a few seconds, but still, if the idea is that I want to finish a run without dying, then there isn't really a need to save. Oh dear. Oh dear. Okay. Ah, he behaved himself. On the door. Start doing that. Whoa, I almost fell. So despite the fact that it looks like you could just walk onto those platforms at any point in time when they come up to the edge, if it's actually just like one... the platforms are split into thirds, basically. Like, there's the right, the middle, and then the left. And if you are just dropping down onto one of the outer thirds of the platform, you actually won't catch it at all. You'll just fall. For whatever reason. So you need to be exceedingly careful about jumping onto them. So, like, right there, I jumped onto the middle, and then when it came into the, you know, the edge, it shoves you over so that you're sitting on it. So you can stand on the outer edges of those platforms, but you can't land on them. Weird, but whatever. I haven't gotten a good pattern from this boss in a really long time. So the good pattern is that he shoots these little, like, you know, balls at you. And what you can do, because you don't have the Rosaria boots, the cleats that stop you from sliding, what you can do with that is that you basically run directly at the boss, and then you press down to slide underneath the shot. Oh my god! Ugh, why? So you press down to slide underneath the shot, and then you force it into the corner with the Fuego magic. And then once it's forced into the corner, it actually can't jump properly, it just jumps up against the ceiling. At which point, like, it can't get away. And then you just continually force it into the corner with more and more shots. And the shots sit on top of its hitbox, and because, you know, hey, the bosses don't have invulnerability frames either! Whoa. Just calm down, dude. Know that I'm gonna live through this. Okay. It's fine, I guess. Wait, aren't you supposed to give me a full heal? Oh no, that's the next boss. Cheapskate. Doesn't even give me a key or anything. Anyway, that's about the worst kind of pattern that you can get from that guy, and I just keep getting it. So anyway, this takes us to the graveyard, which I'm guessing a fair amount of people watching maybe haven't seen at this point. So I get a really kick-ass spell, Lanzar, right here. It's like this fire lance. And it has a lot of charges, which is really nice. But I'm really going to need all of them in this area. Because I've really gotten to the point now where my sword is just completely incapable of, you know, like, killing anything that I'm running up against at this point. So I'm going to need both of these spells to deal with any of the enemies that I'm running into in this area. Which is kind of convenient anyways, because these zombies here that take the two shots, I have to hit them in the head, which is kind of inconvenient with a sword that is this small. I'll just wait for them. Ow. Whoa. Alright. So this is my first equipable item in this run. They're called the Piraka Shoes. The plot device for them is that they're meant to protect you from this blue crap called Gelroid. Gelroid is just spikes for this area. Oh god, so this is why I buy the Juin Fruit. There are a couple of sections in here that are, not friendly in any way, shape, or form. Interesting thing about the Piraka Shoes, though, is that they actually work on any spike damage source in the entire game, not just the Gelroid. And I do get a little bit of traction out of them later for some spikes in a couple of the different caverns. So again, like the other jellies, these ones will multiply if I hit them with a sword. Not that I would at this point anyways, because, well, you know, no damage. But I will be getting a sword that actually does damage very soon here. Okay. I picked up a crest just like a moment ago. And the dude at the weapons shop is looking for it, so he will trade me one of his finest swords, which is a knight sword, for that particular crest, which will increase my base damage from 1 to 8. My damage is also modified by my level. You basically take your level and divide it and round down, and that is your damage. So, at this point, you know, I'm doing somewhere around, like, I don't know, 12 or something, maybe, 10, 12. So I do have a real sword now, which means that I can actually kill a lot of this stuff in this cavern. You know, these red slimes, of course, are out of that. Hey, alright, we're on to a new boss right here. So this is Vista. He's a real ugly motherfucker. And dangerous, too. I screwed up the rhythm there. You find yourself under those jaws, it's game over. Figuratively speaking. Magic is not effective on Vista, so you really gotta have a sword, and the Knight Sword is the first one that has adequate reach. So you either have to pay, like, around, I don't know, it's like 30,000 for the sword, or trade the crest, which is a much better idea. Besides, you have to go by the crest anyways to get the key for that area, so why not? So right here I'm buying my first piece of armor in the game. It's the Honor Shield. So armor in this game will absorb damage that I take from the front, or some percentage of it. So, most of the damage that I take from the front will actually go onto the shield's durability of 300. I still take full damage from the back, and I still get into big trouble if I wind up inside the hitbox of a monster or boss or anything like that, or attack. You stay away. I don't trust you. Alright, so there's a really long platform cycle here that I have to wait for, so I crank that up to speed 9. It's actually a little bit dangerous because there is a chance that there are some of those, like, flying weird octopus head dudes that'll just fly out of nowhere. And at speed 9, I will not be able to react to it. But it is, it's a really long time to wait, so I don't. Okay, that's annoying. So this is actually the first point in the game where I'm going to be getting a sufficient amount of experience to level up from the monsters that I'm killing. So I actually do need to kill a certain amount of these things as I make my way through these winding caverns. I really don't like where that's put me as far as my health is concerned, so I'm actually going to use my second Juin fruit here. So these are those Silkarn shoes I was talking about. So you notice I can just run right up that slant right there. Well, not run, but hop. Something like that. Sure. You also note that I'm killing that guy, or that I killed that little floating head thing with one hit instead of two. And whenever you're doing the down thrust in this game, it doubles your damage. So that's why. I can kill those guys with one hit in that fashion rather than the. Rather than not. Alright, so I need to stop in the bank here and exchange my almas. The exchange rate is nowhere near as good, in fact it's half as good as it was last time, but I need the money. Not that I'm gonna buy much here. I am gonna repair my shield, which is actually super cheap. Having a shield when you're playing this game casually is a really good idea. The ones that you get earlier in the game are smaller. So they don't cover as much for the purposes of blocking, like, you know, projectiles and that kind of thing. But they do save your ass, and you gotta take care of them. Alright, cool. So we are heading towards the boss fight of this area now. Collected all the crap I need. That thing is going to become inconvenient later, so it needs to die now. Thankfully, I can just snipe him through the wall. I don't think that I can get on top of this thing here, can I? Hey, alright. Better than climbing all the way back up here, I guarantee it. Yeah, so this is where that guy would be, just a giant punk. Okay, so this is another boss. My magic isn't going to be very effective here, so it's mostly going to be on the back of my sword damage. So this is big time. I mean, you know, like the shield absolutely helped out in the last area, but Tarso will really just stomp all over you if you do not have a shield here. You can already see, like, I've lost quite a bit of health, and the shield itself is taken quite the beating as well. Alright, so this finds us into the Fire Cavern and Llama Town. So the first thing I'm going to do in Llama Town here is visit the Sage and get the new magic spell, but I'm not going to level up yet. I can, but I'm not going to do that yet. So this woman has a problem because, I don't know, I guess she was, you know, making, you know, some jello for her kids or something and there was like a huge accident. So I used the spell to totally blow that thing out of the water. And now I'll go back and get that level up, which will not only restore my health, but it will also refill my my spells. Which is pretty ideal. So here I'm going to be buying... Actually, hang on a moment. I gotta check my inventory. Okay, good. So I'm going to be buying two more Juin fruits. At 900 a pop. Pretty expensive. And then I'm going to be buying two more Saber Oils. Because I want to have three for this boss. So, that's me affording everything very nicely right there. And now we'll go in and get that level up. So I'm actually going to be trading a substantial amount of my almas here. I think it's 2,500. Yeah, to this guy. He's going to give me a cape made of asbestos. Cancer hype. And the cape is going to prevent me from, you know, taking fire damage in this cavern. So this is a spike item right here, these like little flames on the floor. So I can use my Piraka shoes to prevent getting totally ruined by them. Which is good, because I need to be not ruined for this next section. Because I am about to take a ton of damage. I'm also going to use my Saber Oil now. So I get damage boosted by this blue... Ooh, that's actually not good. I took a lot of damage there. More than I should have. But I should be okay. Provided this guy does not kill me. It's fine. Hoi-yoi-yoi. So as you see, Lanzar still actually does enough damage to, like, kill things at this point. Oh my god, I'm so dead! I need to last to the next screen with, like, yeah, this is fine. Oi! Because I can get a health potion at this point. It's no problem. There's one right up here. So Saber Oil. So Saber Oil is, as you would imagine, something for my sword. So it takes my current damage value, taking, you know, like my level and my base sword damage into account, and then multiplies that by 230%, and they stack. So instead of doing, you know, 10 or 12 damage or something like that, I'm now doing, you know, a lot. Which I'm going to need for the boss fight that's coming up, because this boss is very hard and has a lot of health and likes to absolutely obliterate me. And he's really just a jerk. That's fine. So this is the area where I got blown out by these blue dogs before. There are invisible air currents, like, everywhere in here. And if I fall into them, I'm really screwed. Hey, Fox Nightscape. Hey, Trithrice. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, cancer run. Okay, so last time I was here, this guy was just a shit. So hopefully... Do not block me in this corner. I'm actually going to use one of these for safety. I'm going to use the other one for safety. Oh my god. Come on. Stop being a shit! I told you this was gonna happen. I said this was going to happen earlier. So dumb. So dumb. This is the final spell in the game. It's called Guerra. It's like, you know, holy lightning or something like that. And holy shit, does it do a lot of damage. Any regular enemy in this game will die instantaneously if I cast this spell. Alright, so I'm coming down here to get this Lion's Head key. Because I need it to open a secret door several labyrinths ago. So I'm actually going to enter this room, which is a trap. It sends you back to the past. But it is, in fact, exactly where I need to go as far as the Lion's Head door is concerned, which is this one right here. So in here, I'm going to get the Feruza shoes, which increase my jump height, and I'm also going to get the Sword of the Fairy Flame, also known in the game as the Enchantment Sword. The Enchantment Sword is a little bit better than, like, the Knight Sword. So the Knight Sword had, you know, like, a base damage of 8, and this has a base damage of 255. So it's pretty good. You know, it's an improvement, right? I actually really don't like the fact that I don't have any magic spells, but it shouldn't be an issue. Good. So this is another place where I gained time. I fell and I had to wrap the world. So the labyrinths in this game wrap both vertically and horizontally, so if you screw something up, there's a chance, depending on where you screwed up and what labyrinth it is and, you know, which cavern specifically, you can fix it. Maybe. And that's one of those areas for me. That was an area where I could, you know, fix the problem. I have to do this, because otherwise this guy will just shoot me off of the thing. Alright. So this is going to be my last town visit. This is Esco. So I'm coming in here. It's sort of like the inn, only I don't have to pay. Which is nice. Yeah, that green turn. Alright. So, it's Scrooge McDuck time. Okay, so I'm going to buy a single Juin fruit. And then I'm going to buy 4 Saber Oils. So keep in mind, a Saber Oil will multiply my damage by 230%, and they stack. I think I bought all 4 there, didn't I? How many do I have? I actually have to change the speed before going into my inventory, because if I don't, it just cycles in and out. So I'm also buying a titanium shield here, which not only has way better durability, but it actually takes less damage per hit. Than my previous. than my previous shield. Speaking of saber oils, though, they don't run out until I revisit, like, a town or something like that, and I'm constantly forgetting to use them in this split, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use them right now, because then when I forget later, it doesn't matter, because I've already used them. That makes sense, right? Okay, so this is the most challenging platforming part of the game. Catching onto that rope is really quite hard. I mean, I don't have to deal with, you know, like, ice here, but these jumps are actually more challenging. Okay. Okay, I'm through. Getting onto that fast-moving platform right there and then catching that rope is, I don't know. It's difficult for some reason. So, these blue things need to die. I actually need to take a lot of damage right here to set up a glitch. So when you pick up a full heal potion, it will continue to full heal you until it has completed giving you, like, your entire health bar. Even if you lose health, which means that you cannot be killed. You can't be killed while it's healing you. So I abuse that fact to kill, you know, whatever that guy's name is. Yeah, somebody. And this takes us right into the final boss fight. With Jashin. So, Jashin teleports around like an enormous dick, and then casts spells at you. Though, great thing, he can't teleport into a wall, so I just have to wait in this corner. And then he tries to run away like, you know, a chicken, so I just smoke his ass with my superior magic and he dies. So, this is a pretty good fight. Keep in mind, Trissy Lion, that, you know, that damage multiplication, man. It's legit. Hey, alright.